Kaylee, and this is my November reading wrap-up. I read 26 books in November. I read 0 classics. Oh no. I don't know what happened. Somehow I just didn't end up reading any classics. It's kind of weird for me, but November was just not a classics month, I guess. I read 3 middle grade, 3 children's books, 8 nonfiction, and 12 picture books. If you like this video, please do subscribe and give this video a like. I read the second book in the Lark Light series by Philip Reeve. This one is Starcross. I loved the first book, and the second book did not disappoint. Myrtle and her brother Arthur are having adventures again. This time they are visiting a seaside hotel called Starcross that is located in the asteroid belt. There are mysterious disappearances and strange beings lurking around the hotel. And it's up to Myrtle and Arthur and their friends to save the British Empire. I just love everything about this book. The plot, the characters, the world building, the hilarious writing, the mystery, the adventure, it's all fantastic. I am just amazed at how imaginative this fantasy world is. The aliens and their strange cultures are all so intricate and well-formed. And I just love that it's set in this steampunk 1850s British Empire with space travel. It's such an interesting just solar system, and every planet has its own history and its own people. And this second book further expanded on the world by including time travel. The writing style is really humorous, with that sort of dry humor that I love. I was delighted with so many of the characters and their character development throughout the story. I can't wait to read more books in this series. I gave this one 5 stars. I read The Lost Kingdom of Bemar, which is a prequel to The Two Princesses of Bemar by Gail Carson Levine. Peri is the adopted daughter of Lakhti noble parents, but her real parents are Bemar servants. Her true bloodline is kept a secret because the Bemar people are considered to be inferior and cowardly. The fairy Helena visits Peri and urges her to free her Bemar people. So Peri plunges into espionage and rebellion against the Lakhti tyranny. I really liked Peri's character. She is kind of awkward, but she's a strong person and she's willing to learn. I love how she interacts with the different characters based on whether it's a Lakhti person or a Bemar person. There are so many social dynamics that have to be understood and navigated through. She gradually starts to learn more about her birth heritage and her Bemar family, and she tries to build a new life for herself. The world building is really excellent. There are so many layers to the history and the cultures of the Lakhti and Bemar people. Their different manners, their attitudes, their customs. All of these are explored as Peri learns the difference between the Lakhti and Bemar. They all have different values and priorities, and that affects their behavior and how they interact with one another. It's really intricate and just beautifully explored. The plot is good, with plenty of intrigue and action. I really loved the magical elements in the story. There are some serious scenes, but then there's some humor to balance things out. The writing style is excellent. It plunges the reader into the story and it tugs on your emotions. However, I did not like the way that the ending was kind of rushed. It was just all a little too convenient and quick. After all that buildup, it was just a little disappointing. Not that the ending is terrible, it's fine. It's just, if the ending had been a little better, it would have been a 4-star book for me. But as it is, I ended up giving it 3 stars. I enjoyed it. There are some really good elements in there, but it just didn't blow me away. I read The Borrowers Afield, which is the second book in the Borrowers series by Mary Norton. I loved seeing how the borrowers survive in the wild, outside of a house. They have to fight off insects and gather nuts and berries, and they find shelter in an old boot. The plot in this one has so many interesting little twists and turns. As the Clock family meet Spiller, a borrower who lives in the fields and hedges. They're such funny characters with grit and determination. Pod is resourceful and serious, but he does crack a joke now and then. And Homily is really fearful, but she has this reserve of courage and this inner fortitude that comes up during a crisis. And of course, Arietti is adorable and sweet. She's plucky and adventurous and playful. And Spiller is mysterious and taciturn. I just love them all. The dialogue is fantastic. You can really imagine them sitting around their little fire, drinking rosehip tea from acorn cups and discussing whether or not they could grind up wheat stalks to make bread or whether you shouldn't grind up corn instead. Their personalities really shine through the dialogue. I just love this whole series, and I gave it 4 stars. All of the following books in this video are ones that I received from a publisher in exchange for a free and honest review. So I read quite a few nonfiction books for Nonfiction November. I read The Coolest Stuff on Earth, A Closer Look at the Weird, Wild, and Wonderful. This one's from National Geographic, so you know it's fantastic. And I read Brain Candy 2, Seriously Sweet Facts to Satisfy Your Curiosity. And I read Nerdlit Animals. This is a smaller version of the nerd books that Nat Geo puts out, and this one is all focused on animals. And I read Space Encyclopedia, A Tour of Our Solar System and Beyond. This one has amazing constellation maps and information about the solar system. I read 2 books from Barefoot Books, Incredible Animals and Amazing Places. Both of these got 5 stars, very cool. And I read Southeast Foraging, 120 Wild and Flavorful Edibles from Angelica to Wild Plums. This one had some really good information and very detailed photographs. And I read Timeline, Science and Technology, which gives a timeline of history of the developments in science and technology. All of these books that I just mentioned have really colorful and vibrant illustrations and photos. They all have excellent information that will spark your curiosity. I think I gave all of these 4 and 5 stars. And I read 3 children's chapter books. I read Little Lion Rescue, which is about a girl who is transported to an African plane and she rescues a little lion cub. And I read The Mystery Kitten, about a girl who discovers a little lost kitten in the attic of her new house. And I read Maylee and the Maze, which is about a girl who is trying to become a writer and she finds inspiration in a maze. All of these are just perfect for children who are just starting to read on their own. They're starting to read chapter books by themselves. So there's a few illustrations and the chapters are pretty short, maybe 10 pages each. These are really great books to inspire young readers. I gave all of these 4 and 5 stars. And now the picture books that I read. I read The Kiosk, Sarah's Solo, Voy a Portarme Muy Bien, which is I'm going to behave myself, Un Vampiro Peligroso, a dangerous vampire, The Last Hazelnut, The Tiny Baker, Dance Like a Leaf, Hello Neighbor, The Kind and Caring World of Mr. Rogers. ¿Quién se comió mi pastel? Who ate my cake? ¿Quién se comió mi fruta? Who ate my fruit? Clarice, The Chicest Mouse in Paris. And Clarice, The Fashion Show Fiasco. All of these picture books are so adorable with beautiful illustrations and really cute characters. I gave them all 5 stars with the exception of The Kiosk, which I gave 3 stars. And those are the 26 books that I read in November. Please leave me a comment down below and let me know what was your favorite book that you read in November. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe and remember the right book in the right hands at the right time can change the world.